Hello, my name is Carly McAvoy, and today we're talking about the Cartesian Coordinate System. The Cartesian Coordinate System was named after René Descartes. That's why it's called that, because it was his idea. And you've seen the Cartesian Coordinate System before. If you ever played Battleship, that's using a Cartesian Coordinate System, or if you've ever looked on a map to find the distance between two cities, or something like that, you've used the Cartesian coordinate system. So some vocabulary terms that we all need to be aware of. First of all, x-axis. When you have a Cartesian coordinate system, you have an axis running vertically and horizontally. So the one that's horizontal is the x-axis. And the vertical one is the y-axis. And then each of these axes have, there's a grid, because each of these lines represents a number. So we would say 1, 2, 3. Notice the numbers don't go in between the lines. They fall exactly on the lines. And so we know exactly where 5 is. It's not somewhere in between here. It's right at this point here. And then that's the positives, and they go forever in that direction. And then the negatives would be also on the lines and going in the opposite direction, -4, -5, just like the real number line. And for the that's the horizontal axis. For the vertical axis, we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so forth forever, positive as you go up and negative as you go down. And so forth. I don't know why that one I went to 6, but what about the origin? Well, if you look at the number lines that we're looking at, the vertical and the horizontal, they meet right here, and that's the 0 point. It's 0 for the x-axis and for the y-axis. So that is the origin. The origin is the 0 point for both of the axes. And when we get ready to plot points or name points or whatever, we always want to be aware of the origin in order to do that correctly. And then we have quadrants. If you look at the two lines, it divides up the paper into 1, 2, 3, 4 different sections. And that prefix quad means 4, so we have 4 areas. And when we talk about quadrants in math, we use Roman numerals. So the first quadrant is right here, and that's the first one because a lot of times in the world, we talk about things that only have positive values. Like if you were talking about your salary, you can't make negative money, but you can make positive money, right? If you're talking about time or distance, we're talking about positive, not negative. So a lot of times, things that we work on only fall into that first quadrant. And then it goes counterclockwise. So this is the second quadrant. This is the third quadrant, and finally this is the fourth quadrant down here using Roman numerals. And then every time you want to put a point on your coordinate system, you use something called an ordered pair. An ordered pair is written as parentheses, some number, I'll call it A, comma, some number, I'll call it B, like that. It's got a comma in between, it's got parentheses around it. That's how you write an ordered pair. And if we talk about ordered pair, it's alphabetically ordered, so we always want to think about the x and then the y coordinate. Okay, so if I'm starting at the origin and I want to plot the point, let's say I want to plot the point 2, 4. That is telling me this is the x coordinate and this is the y coordinate. Here's 2 on the x and here's 4 on the y. And if we go to where those two things meet, that's the point 2, 4. 2 on the x, 4 on the y. That's an ordered pair. Every point on the coordinate system requires an ordinate pair to name it. An ordered pair to name it. If we want to name this point, we need to use an ordered pair. If we want to use this point, we need to use an ordered pair. So ordered pairs are the way that we name the points on the system. All right, have a fantastic day. I'll see you next time.